personalized medicine we are talking here about is the selection of treatment on the results of biological or molecular tests of the tumor that may offer you an additional treatment option in top of the standard treatment available. That's what personalized medicine means in our meeting here. Then there are false hopes and fears. There are exaggerated expectations regarding the response, regarding the survival or cure that these kind of treatments may offer, and probably also the likelihood that your tumor actually has the target that can be used in personalized medicine, which is only in a minor fraction of the patients, unfortunately. Then I encounter some diffuse fears, especially in Europe. The patient fear that they are getting exposed to some genetically modified substances, and they have reservations about it. One patient told me, "I don't eat gene food, why should I get these shots?" Then there are other problems. There are difficulties in getting material for testing for personalized medicine, and this may be a strain to the patient because they have to undergo repeated biopsies to have enough material to do the testing. And then there are difficulties in access to personalized medicine because the personalized medicine, the drugs, the specific drugs are not easily available everywhere. And they also cost a lot. The coverage of the costs may be a problem even in high-income countries as Switzerland or other Western European countries. So it's sometimes very hard to get difficulties on funding for personalized medicine. All these things have to address from the Cancer Patient Working Group, from ESMO, for other organizations, to explain the situation and to have a realistic picture what personalized medicine really can offer.